खुदी को कर बुलंद इतना कि हर तकदीर से पहले खुदा बंदे से खुद पूछे, बता तेरी रजा क्या है।
तू रहीम है, तू करीम है, तेरी जात सबसे अजीम है। तू रहीम है, तू करीम है, तेरी जात सबसे अजीम है। तो करम भी कर मेरे हाल पे, है जो मुश्किलें सब टाल दे। सुन ले तू मेरी दुआ, अल्लाहुम्मा सल्ले अला मुहम्मद व अलैहि, अल्लाहुम्मा सल्ले अला मुहम्मद व अलैहि। तेरे दर पे सर को झुका लिया, जो कभी मिला ना वो पा लिया। मुझे अपना बंदा ए खास कर, हो जा रूबरू मुझे पास कर। हर एक निशा मेरी जात का, पढ़ता रहे बस ये दुआ, अल्लाहुम्मा सल्ले अला मुहम्मद सल्ले अला मुहम्मद वालही। जर्रे जर्रे में तेरा ही है वजूद, सांस ये मेरी तेरी अमानत है। तेरे दम से ही मेरी दुनिया सलामत है। मुझे मौत का अब डर नहीं, कहे लोग क्या ये फिकर नहीं। तेरी खाक पर ये जबी मेरी घिसती रहे हर दम सदा, अल्लाहुम्मा सल्ले अला मुहम्मद सल्ले अला मुहम्मद वालही, अल्लाहुम्मा 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 सल्ले अला मुहम्मद वालही।
बंदे हैं हम उसके, हम पे किसका जोर। उम्मीदों के सूरज निकले चारों ओर, इरादे हैं फौलादी हिम्मती हर कदम। अपने हाथों किस्मत लिखने आज चले हैं हम।
construction of our school. Here, I would like to take an opportunity to invite our very own flamboyant principal ma'am. She is the divine force who keep our school lively. Please welcome her with an applause. A very good evening to one and all present here. The honorable dignitary, Mrs. Juvairia Siddiqui, the principal, Princess SM Girls High School. We are glad that you have given your time to us, ma'am. It's an honor for the school. Parents and my dear teachers, it really gave me an immense pleasure to welcome you all on the occasion of graduation of pre-primary, that is PP2, and annual day celebration of our school. We believe that parents are partners in education, and I am proud to say that the school has escalated to the great horizon of success with, of course, parent support and cooperation. The academic progress in our children is possible because of my excellent team of teachers whose dedication and passion in teaching have created a benchmark in the part of the city. From the humble beginning, which happened in 2017, having crossed many measurable milestones, today our school has become a dream destination for many. I wish to celebrate the school's success, expressing gratitude to Canopus family, whose wisdom and missionary zeal inspired many people to be part of our family. It is a matter of pride for me to lead my competent team and demanding parents like you, who always make us prompt in our work. A big applaud to Canopus parents. As today's program is dedicated to our parents, I would take the opportunity to tell you that Canopus is a school with difference. I hope everybody knows that our program, that is the annual day of Canopus School, the second annual day is dedicated to our parents. So I want a loud applause for all the parents, all the enthusiastic parents sitting over here. Why do I feel that Canopus is different? When my little children walk into the school, they set a purpose for us, for our existence in the school. They are the ones who make us believe that they are going to make a difference in their thoughts, beliefs and actions. Canopus doesn't focus only on academics. For us, education doesn't stop with marks, it goes way beyond marks. And I have to convince my parents why I am stating this. It's my humble request to each parent here, please do not attach too much importance to grades. Do not put this into your child's mind to stand first in the class, which every parent wants. And making your child run in this stream is not serving the purpose. Let your child understand and relate life experiences with learning. Give quality time to your child interacting rather than spending your time socializing with gadgets. Socializing, which is, you know, very common nowadays with us. Even I am a parent, and what I feel, what I understand, this is what I am expressing, and I hope everybody take this positively. I am sure everyone here agrees with me that we want our children better than us. Do we all agree? Do we all want our children to be better than us? I want my children to be better than us. My children, that is my Canopus children, Canopus students. It makes me feel proud when I see my students surpass me. So together, let us realize and reflect on our parenting. I have observed that many of the parents talk very disrespectfully towards teachers. Please take this positively as I am expressing what I have observed, so that my parents, you know, as I have got a chance to interact with my parents, so I am expressing my thoughts, and I hope everyone take this positively. I have observed that many of the parents talk very disrespectfully towards teachers. in front of their children. Please do realize that their attitude, this attitude of yours, is actually ruining your child. In what way it is ruining? Your child is developing negative attitude, negative thought, and this in turn is reflecting you. You are the one making your child disrespectful towards teachers. If you are talking disrespectfully about the school and teachers in front of your child, then your child in turn is actually disrespecting teachers, which we as elders never want. I empathize with such children. It is a common question from parents the moment child enters home: what went wrong in school? How many of you agree with this sentence, with this statement? Do we ask our children, what went wrong in school? Is this the question we place in front of them? Now the child starts thinking that actually something went wrong. So what are we trying to ask the child? Pick up only the negative aspects happen in the school. And this is what you are making your child understand. Please don't do that. When you are interacting with your child, when the child comes to you, comes home, please make sure that you ask the child about the happenings in the school rather than asking him what went wrong. I would appreciate if you give respect to school and teachers. Your child would develop the attitude of respecting others, including parents. Some of my school parents believe that school is meant only for imparting academics. The vision of our school is to make competent citizens to face this ever-changing and challenging world. My students who walk out of my school actually reflect my school standard. They possess confidence, intelligence, and aim to become a respectful individual. And this is what we are working on. We want our children to walk out of our school with confidence, with respect, and with aim and intelligence. This is what we are building. So along with academics, we have to plan many activities which can develop all these qualities in them, qualities in children. I humbly request my school parents to encourage and let your children be a part of every program we plan and organize in our school. If your child is learning dance, then he is actually developing his intelligence, remembering his dance steps. If he is reciting a poem, he is actually developing his intelligence along with his posture, his attitude, his confidence to face the crowd. All his senses, his reflexes become active and sharp. This is what we want to see in our children as parents. Do you all agree with me? Do you all agree that we want to see our children possessing all these qualities, what I said just now? A big yes, I want to hear. Yes. Then from now on, I hope that my parents would definitely cooperate in whatever the program I organize or plan for my children. Is that so? I want a louder yes. Children are the mirror. What they see and hear, they do. Let me end up my words reading these lines. These lines which I have already written in the invitation card, I want you all to give a thought on these lines. Every word, movement, and action has an effect. No other person or outside force has a greater impact or influence on a child than a parent. So you are the real heroes for your child. All applauds to all our beloved parents. All applauds. Enjoy the evening. We have many such programs to come up with. I hope everybody goes home happily satisfied, thinking that cannabis has reached its aim. Thank you.